Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we're going to learn a concept, a tutorial on horizontal analysis of the financial statement. Let's understand this. See, horizontal of the financial statement is one of the most important technique to find out how company is doing financially, okay? And it is used for evaluating the trends or year, and it's called year on year, that's called YOY, or Q on Q, that's called quarter on quarter, that's QOQ, right? So in this article, we or in this tutorial, we will have a closer look at the horizontal analysis of the financial statement. Now, first and the foremost thing, what exactly is the horizontal analysis? See, if you are an investor and thinking about investing in a company, only a year-end balance sheet or income statement, it wouldn't be enough for you to judge how company is doing. So you need to look at a couple of years at least to be sure. So better yet, if you see many years of balance sheet and income statement and make a comparison among them. Now, through horizontal analysis of the financial statement, you would be able to see, you know, two actual data, okay? Actual data for the consecutive years, and would be able to compare each and every item. And on the basis of that, you can forecast the future and understand the trade. So you don't need any special financial, you don't need any financial skills to ascertain the difference between the previous year's data and the last year's data. All you need is the diligence. And attention of the details, you can say, of a logical mind to decipher why the change exactly happens. Now, this is the example of GKSR income statement of 2006-2007. Then there is the increase in from 2006 to 2007 has been noted down here. And percentage, that is YOY change, that is the current year, that is 2007 amount 847401. Minus the base year 801240, divide by the base year amount, that is 80210. So by that you will get all this kind of percentages. Now, why provision for taxation has increased close enough to by 12.6%, and that while the revenue has increased by only 5.5%. See, this is quite visible to us. This is the operating expenses, 5.5% EBITDA, EBIT, and so on and so forth. You can see the details, right? See the provision of taxes, 12.6%. So in the GKR example above, we are able to, you know, identify the YOY growth rate using the horizontal analysis. Now, horizontal analysis helps us to identify the potential area of the growth and the concerns from this particular. So for example, in GKSR over here, we note that the provision for tax has increased by 12.6%. However, their revenue has increased by only 5.5%, if you can just see. So why provision increased at a higher rate? That is a question. Also, there has been comparatively, this 5.5% is your net revenue, right? And also there has been a comparatively higher growth rate of 9.1%. I mean, in the selling and the admin cost, right? So what could have contributed this increase? See, as we see, are able to correctly identify the trends and also come up with the relevant areas to target further analysis. Let's have a look at the horizontal analysis formula. See, first we need to take the previous year and the base year. This is the previous year, the base year and the last year as the comparison year. Like for example, let's say we are comparing between 2006 and 2017. We'll take 2006 as the base year and 2007 as the comparison year. Now, the horizontal analysis can be done with this formula, right? We just discussed. Okay, now I'll take the next example. Let's assume that, you know, we are provided with the income statement data of, let's say, company ABC over here, and we need to perform some horizontal analysis on this company. So as you can see, a couple of details are there: sales minus COGS, which gives you a gross profit. You deduct the expenses, so you get the total operating expenses, which gives you your operating income, interest expense, if any. Right, and finally your profit before tax, income tax, and the net income. So this is a very basic example where we have divided our approach into two parts. First, we find the absolute difference between the comparative years. Like for example, the change in the sales, 3 lakh minus 28 lakh, right? The change is how much? This is basically the change in amounts, as simple as that. So the amount, this is the change, and we find the percentage by this fashion. We just divide by the base year. So it's something like this. It's the current year less the base year divide by the base year. So that's how we get our answer. Okay, there has been some problem over here. It's fine. So that basically comes down to 7.14%. And likewise, we can do the same for entire calculation in this fashion, right? And for all the entries in the income statement, basically. Now, let's look at the horizontal analysis of Colgate. Now, here we have the YOY growth rates of Colgate's income statement from 2008 onwards to 2015, right? We calculate the growth rate of each of this line items with respect to the previous years, okay? And for example, I'll say that, you know, to find the growth rates of the net sales of 2015, the formula is basically the net sales of 2015. In this case, net sales of 2015 minus net sales of 2014 divided by the net sales of 2014. So that's how you have found out the percentages from this. And here, some of the observation from the Colgate's horizontal analysis. The last 2 years, Colgate has seen a dip in the net sales figure, as you can see. I mean, in 2015, the Colgate saw a degrowth of 0.72% in 2015. Why? The cost of sales over here, if you see that, however, has decreased positively from the company's point of view. And why this is so? The net income has decreased in the last 3 years with much, you can say, from 11.3%, it has gone to even minus 7%. So net income has decreased in the last 3 years, which as much as 36.5% decline in 2015. So from the income statement and the balance sheet, a company, this is basically the interpretation part, I'm saying that, you know, a company may portray pretty good hold on the financial affairs, but as an investor, it's your responsibility to check each item and understand why there is a difference. Your minute attention to details may help you discover something about the company which the company wanted to hide from all the potential investor. So companies can basically, you can say, inflate profit or show undelivered statement by changing few things here and there. But if you pay attention to details, you would be able to discover that's what's actually going within the company. Now, with such analysis, you would be able to understand how the company may do in the upcoming years and what they are trying to accomplish over the years. What's their recent purchase or sales or revenue or net income, fixed assets, and so on and so forth. Like, unlike the other ratios, this technique gives the investor basically an overall picture, you know, of where a company stands in terms of the financial matter, what they are trying to do with the funds, and how profitable the company can be in the near future. Now, horizontal analysis and forecasting in the financial modeling. See, horizontal analysis is very useful in financial modeling and forecasting. There are two approaches. The first is you perform the horizontal analysis on the historical numbers or the data, and the second, step two, that is based on the YOY or QOQ growth, okay, QOQ growth rates, you can make an assumption about the future growth rates. Okay, so based on this, we can finally make some conclusion that from the above examples, it's clear that through horizontal analysis of financial statement, you need to look at each and every item, okay, in the income statement and the balance sheet. You would get a holistic picture of how a company is doing. So before investing in any company, you should do a horizontal analysis of the company's financial statement and go ahead and do what seems appropriate to you.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.